So on these 5 points, then we can move now to Medina. Of course, there are plenty of other things, but I want you to focus on these 5 things. Yes, to summarize it for you. The number one is the transformation from ignorance to knowledge, which is the knowledge transformation. Number two is the character perfection. Number three is the spiritual transformation. Number four, social transformation. Number five, the psychological transformation. Then in Medina, when he moved to Medina, alayhi salatu wasalam, I know you want me to focus on Medina, but I can't focus on Medina without these pillars. Yes, because these are the main pillars which the society of Medina and the believers, everyone, whether they are Medina, outside Medina, they have to live with these pillars. Yes, so these are the main ingredients of the Muslim character, the Muslim belief. So in Medina, again, plenty of things in Medina to talk about, but let me just talk about the very first opening speech the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam delivered. So the opening speech in Medina, when he arrived at Medina sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, "Ya ayyuhan nas." Very short, very precise, very comprehensive speech he delivered, alayhi salatu wasalam. He says, "Ya ayyuhan nas, all mankind, all people." So he's addressing everyone. He didn't say, "Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu," or "Ayyuhal mu'minun," all believers, all you who believe. He didn't say this because in Medina, bear in mind, it's a mixed community. Muslims, non-Muslims, Jews, non-Jews, you name it. So it's a mixed community in Medina. Believers, non-believers, still yet not fully dedicated for Muslims, Medina. So he's addressing everyone, alayhi salatu wasalam. So he says in his opening speech, as Abdullah bin Salam, the narrator of the hadith. And by the way, Abdullah bin Salam at that time, when he heard the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, this very narrator, he was a Jewish rabbi, top Jewish rabbi in Medina. So he said, "I've heard everyone is going to receive the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in Medina, and I went with the crowd to hear and see the so-called prophet or messenger who came to Medina. I want to see him." So he said, "The moment I have seen his face," this is Abdullah bin Salam, "the moment I have seen his face, عرفت أنه ليس بوجه كذاب." I knew that this is not a face of a liar. And Abdullah bin Salam was seeking the truth and trying to find the truth. So he saw the truth coming from the face of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He knew that he is the man which we are waiting for. Then listen, what did he say? He says, "فسمعته يقول." I've heard him saying, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, "أيها الناس," all people, "أطعموا الطعام," feed the food. I'm translating the hadith literally as it is, and I'll comment on it later. He says, "أطعموا الطعام," feed the food, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. "وأفشوا السلام," spread the salam among you, greeting. "وصلوا الأرحام," connect your families. It means have a good relationship with your blood ties or families and relatives. صلوا الأرحام. So this is number three. Number four, he said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, وَصَلُّوا بِاللَّيْلِ وَالنَّاسُ نِيَامٌ. Pray during the night whilst people are sleeping. تَدْخُلُوا الْجَنَّةَ بِسَلَامٌ. You will be admitted to paradise peacefully. That's it. Done. This is his opening speech. No long speeches, no 2 hours speech, no half an hour and a half speech. No, 3 minutes, 2 minutes speech, done. But so deep, so precise, to the extent I call this hadith the foundation of the human society. The foundation of the human society is based on this hadith. So let me take you through the meaning of the hadith. In another narration, we have the Prophet ﷺ says, Ayyuhannas, O people, U'budu al-Rahman, worship al-Rahman, the most merciful. So according to this narration, we have then five pillars. We talked about five pillars in Mecca. Now we have five pillars in Medina. Yeah. So number one is worshiping Allah, the importance of worshiping Allah. It goes without saying, because the whole message is based on monotheism, tawheed of Allah Azza wa Jal, and connecting with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and how to build this relationship between you and him, accountability, responsibility, and so on. So this is number one. Number two, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, At'imu al-ta'am. At'imu al-ta'am, feed the food. It means look after the needy among you. Who needs the food? Who needs the food? Those who are destitute, those who are very poor, those who have nothing to eat. They are so in need. So the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam is telling the community from day one, you have to look after each other, regardless. If he's Muslim, non-Muslim, and he didn't say feed the food to your Muslim neighbor. He didn't say that. He did say, Ayyuhannas, O people. It means you deal with other fellow humans based on humanity, based on your compassion, based on your love. So it's from day one in Medina, it's a message of love, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. At'imu al-ta'am, feed the food. Means have a good heart. Have a good intention, have a good connection with others, feed the food. Yes. So this is number one. It means we should look after each other. We should help and support each other. وَتَعَاوَنُوا عَلَى الْبِرِّ وَالتَّقْوَى, cooperate with one another on piety and good deeds. So it's going in line with the Quranic direction as well. And then he says, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, number three, afshu salam. Afshu salam, spread salam, spread the greeting, spread the cheerfulness in the community. Because when we meet each other, when we communicate with each other, when we greet each other, it spreads peace. So when you smile at someone's face and he smiles back, it's very contagious. Then happiness and goodness and good relationship will be there. And this is exactly what we need in any community, to have a good relationship, to have positive, if you want, communication with each other. Afshu salam. And on this topic of salam, actually, each topic, by the way, we can spend full 4 hours on the importance of spreading salam. And what does it mean? And how many narrations in the Sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ addressing this issue? How many verses in the Quran addressing this issue? So afshu salam, spread greeting, which will spread love and foster love among you. And as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in another narration says, أَلَا أَدُلُّكُمْ عَلَى أَمْرٍ إِذَا فَعَلْتُمُوهُ تَحَابَبْتُمْ أَفْشُ السَّلَامَ بَيْنَكُمْ تَحَابُوا. Shall I not tell you about something? If you were to spread among you this, it will foster love, spread salam among you, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So again, it's a message of love from day one. Spreading salam is a message of love. Then he says, number four, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, silul arham. Silul arham, connect your blood ties, connect your relationships, your relatives, your family, have a good relationship with your family. Okay. And number five is your relationship with Allah. Confirmation of your relationship with Allah. Sallu billayl, pray during the night. away from any hypocrisy and showing off and so on. It's between you and Allah Azza wa Jal. This is, of course, the extra prayer. It's not the obligatory prayer. Yeah. So these are another five things. So five in Mecca, five in Medina.